Good morning, YouTube! Alright, wow, I totally had something really important to say, but it just, like, slipped my mind. But anyways, it is the sixth episode now, and, today I'm actually going to be sitting down with you guys later today to just talk, but, I wanted to kick off the episode with an interesting thought. So, I always, let me show you guys, actually. So, this is my TV. And I'm just like playing my Spotify playlist over here and stuff. But anyways, Bowl 4 came up and I was just like, you know what would be an interesting idea? If you started your day with a specific artist every morning, like if you like Travis, you start with Travis. If you start Kanye, you start Kanye or something like that. Like, I literally listened to Bowl 4 and I was just like, oh. What if I just conditioned my Mondays to be Bowl 4 days? And then, like, Tuesdays would be, like, Red Velvet, Wednesdays would be Blackpink, or something like that. I wonder how effective music conditioning per day of week would be. It's like a scientific experiment that I'm kind of curious about, which I might experiment on later on during the series, but, you know, just food for thought, you know? Wonder if you can condition yourself to be productive in the morning just by the music that you wake up to or listen to. So, anyways, that's enough scientificness for me. I'm gonna get ready to go to work and I'll sit down and talk with you guys afterwards. Welcome to the episode, guys, and I'll see you in the next clip. What's good, YouTube? I am home from work right now. I am absolutely beat from just a killer workout and just a really long work day. So, yeah, just to preface kind of my state of mind right now as I'm filming. But today I wanted to talk about something that's actually really, really important and really under, I guess, spoken or even just like not really touched on by people like me and or our age range, like from like, I don't know, like early 20s, late teens kind of age. And that's just generally fiscal responsibility. And I mean, I think that no one really ever goes through like fiscal responsibility classes or anything to like help them understand what their money does. And so, yeah, I'm gonna do my best. I'm not an expert or a pro by any means, but I'm gonna do my best to tell you guys what I'm personally gonna try and implement in my fiscal spending habits and responsibilities. And so if these things interest you, get ready to listen to my four pointers on things that I'm just gonna do to kind of make myself more physically accountable or responsible. I'm just gonna jump right into it. Number one is gonna be really easy. It's going to be save more than I spend. And so this is gonna be a hard one for me because spending money is generally a lot easier than saving money. And the entire idea behind delayed gratification and, you know, like, putting things away for emergency funds and not whatnot has always been like something that I personally struggled with. Like, saving to spend has always been something that I've done, but saving for the sake of saving is not really kind of in my mental monetary vocabulary. And I really want to incorporate some habit like that, so I'm just gonna make a habit of saving half my paycheck and spending the rest. Hopefully I'll be able to do so, but if I can't save half, I'm definitely gonna go for at least, like, you know, 66% spending and 33% saving. But anyways, that's number one. Number two is going to be investing my money in things that will ultimately provide return. So whether or not this goes towards, like, money markets or Roth IRAs or 401ks, like, this general category of just investing my money so that it can make me more money is something that I really want to try and read more up on and get more into. Tip number three, tracking down literally every expense. And I wanted to do this just generally by keeping a, I guess, comprehensive Excel sheet for a certain period of time, and then using that Excel sheet to document literally every single thing that I spend for the month, and just kind of use that to move money around, save money. Obviously, since I'm not cutting, I'm gonna be spending a lot of money on like food because I'm bulking, but generally seeing where my boundaries lie and how I'm going to navigate spending my money there. And tip number four is going to be really simple, but just spending my money on things that will have lasting value. And that's great news for you guys, because generally speaking, spending on sneakers or hype items, especially if you cop at retail, will continue to have just an increasing lasting value. And so trying to not spend money on activities per se, but more on general items that will return value. But keep in mind, a lot of the spending that I do want to kind of allocate and like plan for generally does lie within experiences, because I mean, since I am in my younger 20s, like early 20s, I think it's important to really experience, travel, and do a lot of those things that a lot of young people do. And so, you know, these are four tips that I really want to incorporate into my, I guess, 22nd year of living, and I hope you guys benefited something from it. I'm not the most financially knowledgeable by any means, but just doing these things, I want to try and keep myself more financially accountable, and moving forward, I just really want to have more money. Who doesn't want to have more money, you know? And so I hope you guys take these tips to heart, and I hope that it was helpful. Sharing my own practices has always been something that I'm like really, really like iffy on, because I'm not the greatest by any means. Like, I never claim to be the greatest, and I don't claim that my methods are going to be steel proof, like tested and working. But I mean, if you guys think that my logic behind my monetary kind of tips makes sense and want to adopt them to your own life, go for it. I welcome it, and I really want you guys to share like generally things about financial responsibility and like things that you do in your day-to-day life. Oh, speaking of which, let's get to the comments of the previous video really quick. And so, Oh, there's actually only one comment on the skincare routine video, and it is Skincare Prove says, "Many thanks, this video is extremely practical." Thank you very much. I try to make a lot of my videos more and more practical, even like generally to the structure of my like sneaker reviews and hype item reviews. I want to make it as practical as possible. So getting that comment is really, really humbling, and thank you very much for contributing to the comment section. Of course, if you guys have any comments about general fiscal responsibility or things to make you more fiscally responsible, I'd love to hear it. Like, honestly, any tips that you have that you guys use, or any questions about my tips, or, you know, anything really, just let me know in the comment section down below. I'll always be excited to listen in, and I'm always open to having conversations about it, because I feel like conversations about this topic are really slid under the rug, or like under the door, or something like that. You know, one of those, you know, idioms and sayings. It goes to say that it's really underspoken, and so it's something that should be focused on in our generation. Well, thank you guys for listening to me today, and I'll be back again tomorrow. I'm not sure what kind of video I'm gonna do yet tomorrow, but, you know, you'll see tomorrow, and so will I. Anyways, see you guys, take care, and see you tomorrow.